five-star wrestling. Which you know, it's no, I've always heard from all the wrestlers was you got paid, which is the most important thing. You got paid to do what you need to
do. Absolutely.
But when you're seeing all the kind of, I don't know, decisions online, or the choices they were making, was a part of you just trying to take your promoter hat off when you, like you did SWA and stuff? Was it you just trying to take that off and just go, nope, I'm here to do a job. This is what I'm here to do. I don't need to listen to that. I don't need to see what I can clearly see is wrong.
From my own perspective, I was like, I knew it was not going to work because they went too big too fast, and they were approaching these massive venues. Like you're talking about the same venues that WWE does, right? But you don't have the beauty of WWE television being able to advertise what you're doing, you know. So, you know, that was a ready-made advertisement for what WWE does, you know. So when you don't have that, then you're hoping that word of mouth or whatever else will put people in the door. And without like Progress and ICW and RevPro had built their audience, you know. So like without that, you're trying something completely new, completely fresh, and just thinking putting Rey Mysterio on a poster is enough. Like, don't get me wrong, 10 years before that, it would have been enough, and you would have got maybe 10,000 people. But, you know, the way wrestling had gone, people wanted more bang for their buck. They wanted more than just, you know, a name or whatever else. They wanted to know that they're going to be entertained. And it's just the way, it's kind of the way, you know, fans have evolved as well as the wrestling. But like, listen, my experience at Five Star was hilarious. It was me and Nick Aldis against Luke King Sharp. It was the most, and we were the baby faces and he was the heel. Like, that made me realize that they had no idea what they were doing. If they had somebody like with all the knowledge of people that they hired to wrestle, if they had any of them in charge, they might have had a hope of, you know, keeping going. But it was a fella who did a wrestling game who was now booking shows, and he just had no idea what he was doing. And I remember trying to speak to him at one point, and I was just at the end, I was like, what? He's not listening. And you know what? It's just money to me. So I was disappointed because I thought that there maybe could have done something with it. Because you're bringing AJ Styles and Rey Mysterio to, you know, these places, and they're putting 100 people into a 10,000 capacity arena. And I'm just like, what a waste of money, to be honest. But, you know, it was great for us to be on the same show as them. And some of the boys got to wrestle them. You know, for me, I can remember who all I wrestled when I did the five-star stuff. I just remember that first one being myself and Nick Aldis against Luke King Sharp. I just remember thinking, like, you know, as good again heel as Luke King is, there's nobody can sell that match to anybody. Again, it was a good opportunity for me to meet people I'd never met before, and you know, watch some of the other matches, you know, which were fun. But yeah, it was a nonsense. I think it was like a great concept, executed badly. I think that's the best way we can put it. I know that they maybe went above themselves later and tried too many shows and things like that. But you know, they gave it a bash. It was just rare at that time. Anybody who was putting on wrestling shows at that time was generally doing well. And then you've got these guys coming in and really trying hard, like bringing in these massive games and doing badly. And that, if nobody could figure out why, then that's pretty much why it didn't work out, you know. But no, fair play. For us, it was a bunch of fun stories, to be honest. That's the way I look at it, so.
Yeah, I mean, good networking. That's kind of the good network opportunity.
I got to meet AJ. I met him a couple of times at RevPro when we did that. And then the two of us are sitting at Orlando WrestleMania, and he just turns to me and he goes, hey, do you remember that five-star wrestling? So yeah, it was one of those very cool experiences I got well paid, and fair play to the boys. You know, they did that. We got that part done. I don't know how the video game did, if it worked out well for them. I hope it did, you know. I hope it all made sense for them.
I played it, and
was it good?
If it did, then well done to them, because it was a difficult one to play for me. But you know, some people I'm sure liked it. So
this is the equivalent. I guess the equivalent of me deciding tomorrow that I'm going to start doing a football game to go up against FIFA.
Yeah,
Choosing like, yeah, I quite like football. I've watched football all my life. It's a huge passion of mine. But there's no way in God's earth should I do a football computer game. But never mind.